And those who are tired and who are feeling tipsy and sleepy, you know, you are free to heal too. The Mass that we are celebrating is in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Mercy. She's not just a mother to whom we could run, for she understands, but she is also our model in terms of being an instrument, an agent of mercy. Our Blessed Mother was greeted by Elizabeth. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And who am I to be visited by the mother of my Lord? Wow. If we could paraphrase this, Elizabeth was singing the praises of Mary. You are blessed among women. You are the greatest of all women. And imagine, you are no ordinary mother. You are the mother of the Lord. Wow. If Mary were an ordinary woman, she might have responded, well, what can I do? I was favored by God. No, I cannot control it. I'm blessed. And sorry, Elizabeth, you were not chosen. The child that you were bearing is just a precursor. I is the real thing, the Lord. Imagine that would not be possible. That would not be news. There were a lot of questions about humility that turned to Mary. And try to imagine a Mary who is not humble. Imagine how the words of Mary would change in the gospel. And then you will say, this is not anymore the gospel of St. Luke. This is another piece of writing which you will not call good news. She was very much aware that her being a mother of the Lord was an act of God's mercy. It is not something that she deserved. It is not something that she earned. That's why she could not say the praises of herself. She could not say, yes, I am good. I am better than the rest. I am better than all the women. No, she could only say, my soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. For all the good things that are happening to me has been done by God. And who am I? I am a lowly servant. That's the first thing that we learned from Mary. She was very much aware of how the mercy of God worked in her life. And that consciousness was a deterrent to being proud, to exalting herself, and to constantly drawing attention to herself. Rather, she would deflect everything and say, yes, that greeting is meant for God. That praise is meant for God. For God has done great things for me. Holy is his name. Dear young people, when somebody praises you, wow, beautiful air, will you say, my soul? Or will you say, ah? When somebody tells you, congratulations, wow, you landed on the first honors of the school, would you say, that's talent? and may I use this verse to praise His name. But the second thing that we learn from Mary is that in her exalted position, yes, by God's action and grace, she never separated herself from her people, Israel. She did not forget the people to whom she belonged. She did not forget the hungry, the lonely, the suffering people of Israel. In fact, she considered God's action in her life as already a sign of what God will do for her people. That's why she is the mother of mercies. She never became strange to the others. You know, this is something that we have to learn from Our Lady. I hate to say this, but I noticed this among some of our politicians, for example. I can speak for the Philippines. You know, when they are campaigning, they are an ordinary person. They go to the factories. They eat with the workers. They go to the farms. They are one with the others. The moment they get elected, higher, higher, higher. They forget their connectedness with the people, with the hungry. After getting their votes, okay, we are here, you are there. And that's the beginning of corruption. Yes. Corruption, injustice, which are all lack of mercy. Mercy inspires justice. If you are merciful, you will be just. When does injustice begin? When you lose mercy. But that was not the way of Mary. As an exalted woman, blessed among women, she spoke for the suffering people, Israel. And she continues to pray for Israel and for us. My dear young people, Mary unites herself even now with all of you, especially the women. She was a young woman who obeyed God's law, God's will, and put her life at stake. She could have been stoned to death because of her. Yes, because of her submission to God's will. She probably became the talk of the town. Even Joseph wanted to separate from her. But she was brave. She was brave. Then, delivering her child, not in a decent inn, but in a manger, where animals were kept, where they were fed. She became a refugee in Egypt. They had to escape. Then she lost her son, 12 years old, in the World Youth Day in Jerusalem. Being told by the youth named Jesus, why did you look for son grew up, I started teaching, and Mary heard. That man Jesus, he's crazy. He is influenced by the Beelzebub. Imagine your son being accused of working for the devil. He was arrested. His friends left him. But Mary stood at the foot of his cross, as though assuring Jesus, your friends have turned away. You are now a stranger to them. They used to eat with you, walk with you, but because of your bad name now as a criminal hanging on the cross, you have suddenly become a stranger. But don't worry, son. I am here. And I declare it to the world, you are my son. The mother of mercy. The mother of mercy. She knows the sufferings of people. She knows the sufferings of refugees. She knows the sufferings of women, mothers, who lose their children. He knows the sufferings of mothers whose sons or daughters are kidnapped, put to death, left alone. She will never abandon her son, and she will never abandon the brothers and sisters of her son. She is truly the mother of mercy. Let us open our hearts to the spirit that hovered over Mary. May the same spirit transform our hearts into the dwelling place of Jesus, the face of God's mercy. And in turn, like Mary, let us be God's merciful hands, eyes, lips, feet, heart, to many suffering people in the world. They are no strangers. They are neighbors. They are brothers. They are sisters.